But okay, so today we looked at Paulus Hector Mair's Longsword play number 47. And the next 10 plays or so are all around winding, winding, winding. And we begin in a very strange stand, both mirror. So we take our hand like this. And we bind with the short edge. So I have no idea how you can come into in free play to this. You can try, it works. but there's no. okay. So somehow you come in here, and we stand both in the same way. Ach so, that's from this links, yeah. And what Inga now does, so I stand forward with my right foot, she stands forward with her left foot. And from here you have a nice lever. So you can push here in this direction, and this gives you a nice overbind, and your opponent's sword will instantly go onto with his feet on your strong. And from here you can wind around to the other side. But that's her part, sorry. Okay, so. So that's what she does. Brings me around there. She even makes a step to make it more stronger. And from there she winds into my face. If I want to prevent this, I will use my long edge. And so she does this again. And now here. Here's the turning point where I use my long edge, which is down now, and bring it on her weak while she's still in the movement. And from here I go here. And he says so. You come on. Come on. So I parry with my long edge when she comes for me. I parry with my long edge. Then I verfall, so I go down, I bring her here, and I go back up into the unicorn and can step from above. So and then same principle. I have her weak on my strong, and this allows me to control her blade. And that's what winding is all about. It's about control. So, that's it for today. Thank you, Inga. And thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, whatever you like.